Dear friends, I am Dr. K. Kannan, Professor Mechanical Engineering, Anjali Ammal Mahalingam Engineering College. I am happy to meet you again through the video lecture on the subject Engineering Thermodynamics. We are discussing on the Module 6 Steam Power Cycle, and this is lecture number 605. We recap from the previous lecture. So, in the previous 4 lectures, we discussed the reheat Rankine cycle, reheat Rankine cycle, and we derived the efficiency of the Rankine cycle and the reheat Rankine cycle, and we solved problems on the Rankine cycle, problems on reheat Rankine cycle. And this is the topic for today's lecture is regenerative Rankine cycle, and the student will be able to explain the regenerative Rankine cycle, that is the learning outcome. Learning outcome for this lecture is the student will be able to explain regenerative Rankine cycle. And this is the layout of the regenerative Rankine cycle with one feed water heater. So, you look at the layout, take a moment, few seconds, and look at the diagram. We have a boiler, we have a turbine, condenser, pump 1, pump 2, and the reheater. So, this is the new device, heater in the steam power plant, in the Rankine power plant, and from the pump to the fluid, water is going to the boiler again. And the main purpose of regeneration, so we said earlier, there are two methods to improve the efficiency of the Rankine cycle. One is reheating, another one is regeneration. In the reheating, the main objective is to improve the turbine work output, and in the regeneration, the objective is reducing or decreasing the amount of heat supply in the boiler. So, you look at the, we will explain the layout diagram. So, the steam enters the turbine with property 1. So, superheated steam enters at state 1 and it is expanded. So, it is expanded from 1 to 2. And 2 to 3. So, when the steam is expanded, so we have the steam turbine with the multiple stages. In between the stage, after few stages, the steam is taken here at the condition 2. So, certain quantity of the steam. So, m kilogram of the steam is taken here for the heating. The remaining steam is flowing here. So, the remaining steam flows here from between 2 and 3 is 1 minus m kilogram. Assuming 1 kilogram of steam here at the entry of the turbine, 1 minus m kilogram of steam is flowing here. And this 1 minus m kilogram of steam is flowing to the condenser. So, it is expanded and then the outlet is going to the condenser. It is condensed. So, the liquid is converted, vapor is converted into liquid, and this water is pressurized using the pump. And this water enters the heater. So, here in the heater, the incoming water is heated up and the temperature of the water is increased. And the source of heat energy is the bleeding steam. So, the steam with the condition 2, the property 2 is entering here. The water with the enthalpy H5 is entering here. These two are mixed together in the heater. This is open type of heater. It is mixed and the heated. Then it comes out with the state 6. Now, it is again pressurized using the pump and it is supplied back to the boiler at the state H7. So, this is the layout diagram and the corresponding temperature entropy diagram. So, here it is superheated steam. The superheated steam is expanding. 1 kg of steam is expanding up to 2. Right? This is the condition 2. Then further it is expanding up to the condition 3. So, between 2 and 3, the mass of the steam equal to 1 minus m kilogram because m kilogram of steam is going to the heater. Then in the 3, it is outlet of the turbine. 1 minus m kilogram of steam is condensed in the condenser and it is a pump work, first pump work, then it is heating. So, the heating in the heater, feed water heater, then at the point 6, so enthalpy 6 here, it is further pressurized using the second pump. So, H6 to H7 is in the pump 2, then from 7, it is heated in the boiler. So, this is the layout diagram for the one feed water heater, regenerative cycle with one feed water heater. Now, we have to calculate all the working parameter, turbine work, pump work, amount of heat supply, and then we have to calculate the efficiency. So, the diagram once again. Now, the turbine work, So H1 minus H2, where the steam flow is 1 kilogram, H1 minus H2, then H2 minus H3, where the steam flow is 1 minus m kilogram. So H1 minus H2 plus 1 minus m into H2 minus H3, that is the turbine work. And the pump work, again we have two pumps, 4 to 5. So the flow rate is 1 minus m kilogram. So 1 minus m into H5 minus H4 plus H7 minus H6. This is the pump work here. And then the amount of heat supplied, it is H1 to H7. So the now here there is one unknown, H1, H2, H3, H4, H5, H6, H7, all the enthalpy we can calculate from the steam table for the given condition. And the only there is one unknown, M is the unknown, that is mass of the steam taken out for the heater. So the bleeding steam, that is called as bleeding steam. And to calculate the bleeding steam, we have to use the energy balance for the feed water heater. So this is the heat exchanger, feed water heater. So in the feed water heater, m kg of steam with H2 is entering, and 1 minus m kg of steam with enthalpy H5, water with enthalpy H5 is entering. So these two are mixed together, and the enthalpy of the steam leaving, enthalpy of the water leaving the heater is H6. So the energy balance, H6 equal to m into H2 plus 1 minus m into H5. So, knowing the value of H6, H2 and H5, we can calculate the m value here. So, once you know the m value, you can calculate all the other parameter. Then, we calculate the efficiency of the regenerative cycle, which is eta equal to W net, work net to work output divided by the heat supply, which is equal to WT minus WP divided by heat supply. So this is single feed water heater, regenerative cycle with a single feed water heater. Then we take the second cycle, regenerative Rankine cycle with two feed water heater. We take few seconds and look at the diagram. So we have a boiler, we have a turbine, condenser, pump 1, pump 2, pump 3, heater 1, heater 2. So there are two feed water heater. So as usual, we assume 1 kg of steam at the entry of the turbine. So here 1 kg of steam entering here, and in between we are taking the bleeding steam at the state 2 and at the state 3. So from 1 to 2, the flow rate is 1 kilogram. 2 to 3, the flow rate is 1 minus m1 kilogram, because m1 kilogram of steam is taken here for heater 1, and 2 to 3 the flow rate is 1 minus m1 kilogram, and 3 to 4 the flow rate is 1 minus m1 minus m2 kilogram, because another quantity m2 kg of steam is taken for the second feed water heater. So 1 kilogram between 1 and 2, 1 minus m1 kilogram between 2 and 3, 1 minus m1 minus m2 between 3 and 4, then the steam is flowing here. The outlet of the steam turbine, the quantity is 1 minus m1 minus m2 kilogram. It goes to the condenser, it is condensed, converted into liquid. So the water is coming out with the state 5, and we have the first pump, it is pressurized. So the at the state 6, so 6 is the enthalpy of the steam, enthalpy of the water after pumping, after pressurizing. So with the enthalpy H6, it is entering the feed water heater 2. So in the feed water heater, what is the quantity here? 1 minus m1 minus m2. So here we are mixing with the m2 kilogram, and what is leaving? 1 minus m1 kilogram. So 1 minus m1 kilogram of water is leaving the feed water heater, and using the pressure second pump, we are pressurizing further. The enthalpy is H7. So the 1 minus m1 kilogram with the enthalpy H7 is entering the feed water heater, and here we are mixing m1 kilogram of steam, and then here it is mixed and it is leaving 1 kilogram of steam at the condition 9. So again we have another pump here, pump 3. It is pressurized and it is leaving with H10. The enthalpy water is leaving with H10, enthalpy H10, and then it is going to the boiler, where it is heat is supplied and the converted into steam. So this is the layout diagram and the corresponding temperature entropy diagram. So 1 to 2, it is expansion in the turbine 2 to 3, it is also expansion of the turbine. 3 to 4, it is also expansion of the turbine. First 1 kilogram, second 1 minus M1 kilogram, third 1 minus M1 minus M2 kilogram, and here pump 1, H5 to H6, then pump 2, H7 to H8, and then pump 3, H9 to H10. So now we have to calculate the enthalpy. Turbine work. Turbine work equal to H1 minus H2 plus 1 minus M1, because M1 kg of steam is going here, 1 minus M1 into H2 minus H3 plus 1 minus M1 minus M2 kg of steam. So that is what the flowing here, because another quantity M2 is going here, 1 minus M1 minus M2 into H3 minus H4. Then pump work, first pump, 1 minus M1 minus M2 into H6 minus H5 plus second pump, 1 minus M1 into H7, H8 minus H7 plus H10 minus H9. Then the amount of heat supplied QS equal to H1 minus H10. So the energy balance for the feed water heater 1. So to calculate the M1 and M2 value, first we take the feed water heater 1. So for heater 1, M1 into M1 quantity of the steam with the enthalpy H2 is entering here. And 1 minus M1 kg of water with H8 is entering in the feed water heater. These two are mixed together and the enthalpy of the water leaving here is H9. So, the energy balance is H9 equal to M1H2 plus 1 minus M1H8. Then the energy balance for the water heater 2, for water heater 2, the amount of steam entering here is 1 minus M1 minus M2 H6, that is the quantity of water entering here, M2H3, M2 quantity of the steam with the enthalpy H3 is entering in the feed water heater. So, these two are mixed together and 1 minus M1 with the H7 is leaving the feed water heater 2. So, the energy balance equal to 1 minus M1 into H7 equal to M2H3 plus 1 minus M1 minus M2 times of H6. Using this equation, first feed water heater, we can calculate M1. And substituting M1 here, we can calculate M2. Then the efficiency of the regenerative cycle, so eta equal to W net work net, net work output divided by the heat supplied equal to WT minus WP divided by heat supplied. So using this, we can calculate the efficiency of the regenerative Rankine cycle. And the advantages of regenerative cycle over simple Rankine cycle. So the heating process in the boiler tends to become reversible. So, the you can achieve a reversible heat addition process in the boiler. The thermal stresses set up in the boiler are minimized. So, this is due to the fact that the temperature ranges in the boiler is reduced. So, the temperature in the boiler is reduced. So, the thermal stress in the boiler will be minimized. Thermal efficiency is improved because of average temperature of heat addition to the cycle is increased. That is what the objective. So, the objective here is to increase the thermal efficiency of the Rankine cycle by reducing the amount of heat supplied. So, the fourth point, heat rate is reduced. The amount of heat supplied in the Rankine cycle, in the boiler is reduced. The blade height is less due to the reduced amount of steam passed through the low pressure stages. So, because there are two stages in which we are taking the certain quantity of the steam, the amount of steam flow in the lower stages of the turbine is reduced. So, the height of the turbine blade is decreasing. Due to many extraction, there is an improvement in the turbine drainage and it reduces the erosion due to the moisture. So, a small size condenser is required because the quantity of the steam flowing to the condenser is reduced. So, the size of the condenser is reduced. Disadvantages, the plant becomes more complicated because of the feed water heater and piping system, pump, additional pump. So, it becomes highly complicated. Because of addition of heater and a greater maintenance is required. So, we add a heater, we add a pump. So, additional maintenance is required. For a given power, a large capacity boiler required. So, we require a large capacity boiler in the case of regenerative cycle. The heater are costly and the gain in thermal efficiency is not much in comparison with the heavier cost. So, the cost involved in the regeneration plant installation is more in the case of regenerative cycle and the corresponding increase in thermal efficiency is not much appreciable. So we studied the simple Rankine cycle, reheat Rankine cycle, and regenerative Rankine cycle. So normally in a steam power plant of higher capacity, we are using combined reheat and regenerative cycle, not separate reheat cycle or separate regenerative cycle. So there will be combined reheat and regenerative cycle for overall improvement in the plant performance or plant efficiency. We combine the reheat regenerative cycle, and we stop here. So these are all the books I used for preparing slides. You can also refer to it for additional information, and you can write to me for any queries or clarification to my mail ID. I will sincerely answer. So thank you for watching. We'll meet again.